Good day everyone, welcome again to another episode of DAS Training. And today I will discuss to you transaction deem sales subject to value added tax. But before that, I would like to say thank you to all our subscribers. No, maabot na tayo ng 2,800 subscribers. And I'd like to say thank you to all of you, and for those who have not yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel, and I promise to bring you updates on taxation. The aim of this YouTube channel, Tax Training, is to have a better tax compliance. So thank you. Our discussion today would be transaction deemed sales subject to VAT. Kasi ano ba itong transaction deemed sale? Ito yung transaction na hindi naman siya talagang sales kasi walang bindahan, pero magbabayad ka ng value added tax pag meron kang ganitong klaseng transaction. So what are these transactions deemed sale? Acquisitions or consumptions in nature but are not coerced through a purchase transaction by the consumer. Hindi siya bentahan, no? Transactions are not recorded as sales by the seller, no? Nevertheless, since these transactions are forms of taxable consumptions, they are considered deemed sales for VAT purposes. So, hindi siya totoong sale, pero kinoconsider siya na deemed sale for VAT purposes, no? So, pag sinabi na natin na kinonsider na siya na deemed sales, parang sale na siya kahit hindi siya talaga totoong sales, subject siya sa value added tax. So, what are this list of transactions deemed sales? Ito po yung nasa National Internal Revenue Code natin. Number one, transfer, use, or consumption not in the course of business of goods or properties originally intended for sale or for use in the course of business. So, ito yung nasa inventory na natin, kasama sa purchases natin, intended siya na pambenta or gagamitin sa business. Pero, sa totoong disposition natin, hindi siya nabenta, no? Another, number two, is distribution or transfer to, letter A, shareholders or investors share in the profit of VAT registered persons. So, instead of i-distribute natin na share of profits ng shareholders ay pera, halimbawa, kasi profit yan, pero ang kinuha na shareholder are goods or properties na ginagamit na pambenta, so magiging deemed sales pa rin siya, no? Subject to VAT. And letter B, ito yung distribution or transfer na binigay natin sa ating mga creditors in payment of debt or obligation. So, since ang binigay natin are goods or properties, subject siya sa value added tax. No. Number three, consignment of goods if actual sale not made within 60 days following the date such goods were consigned. Number four, retirement from or cessation of business with respect to all goods on hand, whether capital goods, stock in trade, supplies or materials as of the date of cessation, whether or not the business is continued by the new owner or successor. Bakit? Bakit po during retirement or closure ng business, kailangan yung ating goods on hand ay yung disposition niyan or transfer niyan sa new owner, considered sold siya for what purposes? Bakit? Kasi during the time na nag-purchase tayo, ginamit na natin yung input noon, no? So, form part of our inventory wherein pinakinabangan natin yung input tax na 12% doon. Kaya ngayon, naginamit natin siya, dinispose natin siya, magbabayad tayo ng 12% na value added tax. Number five, cessation of status as VAT registered person. Status lang, no? Hindi siya nag-cease ng business, hindi siya nag-close ng business. Pero, halimbawa, nag-change siya ng registration niya from VAT to non-VAT. Kasi, at result ngayon, under the train law is already 3 million at yung taxpayer natin, hindi niya aabuti na yung 3 million. So instead of VAT siya, nagpa-register na siya na non-VAT, nag-change ng registration from VAT to non-VAT. So ano yun? Considered deemed sold din yung kanyang property at na inventories at magbabayad siya ng VAT dun sa transfer. Why? Kasi non-VAT na siya. Transfer not in the course of business. Ano pong ibig sabihin ng transfer not in the course of business? Ibig sabihin, nagninegosyo ka, nandun yun, kasama sa inventory mo, pero nilipat mo siya sa iba, tinransfer mo, pero hindi mo binenta, no? So, not in the ordinary course of business. Kasi ang ordinary course of business, binenta mo. You sold the product. Pero ito, hindi mo binenta. So, what happened? Dim sale siya. No? Example, a business proprietor or partner may withdraw goods or properties held for sale, lease, or use in the ordinary course of trade or business for his personal consumption. So, ano pala ito? Withdrawal. Withdraw mo yung goods or properties mo for personal consumption. No? So, it's not in the course of business or through purchase and will not be recorded as a sale by the business. Hindi talaga siya sale. So, for the purpose of the VAT, this transaction is deemed as a sale subject to VAT. Kasi winidraw mo eh. So, ginamit mo for personal consumption. Babayaran mo yung VAT doon. Example or illustration. A realtor transferred ownership over a residential property which is held for sale to his daughter who is getting married. So, kung ang isang realtor nagbebenta ng residential property, itong residential property considered inventory niya to kasi held for sale, no? So hindi niya to property na residential or capital assets, hindi, ordinary to kasi kasama diyan sa binibenta niya, no? So itong property binigay niya sa anak niya na mag-aasawa na, no? So the property had a cost basis of 2 million and a fair market value of 2,500,000 at the date of transfer. So magkano yung cost ng property? 2 million. Pero yung fair market value niya is 2,500,000. So how do we compute? The output VAT should be computed as follows. Fair market value, 2,500,000 multiplied by 12%, the output VAT is 300,000. So yun po yung value added tax due doon sa property na binigay doon sa anak. So kahit hindi siya binenta, isama mo pa rin siya kasi winidraw mo, tinanggal mo doon sa inventory mo, hindi mo na siya binenta, binigay mo. So, subject pa rin siya sa VAT na 12%. Yun ang sinasabi natin na deem sale transactions. No? Bakit fair market value? Fair market value po ang basis. Kasi wala naman dito na cash involved. So, anong basis natin? The fair market value na 12%. So, how do the taxpayer pay this output tax of 300,000? Isama po niya ito sa kanyang monthly VAT na pina-file. And then compute the total output VAT at compute din the total input tax na i-claim niya. Yung sobra, yun lang yung maging VAT payable niya or refund kung marami siyang input, no? So, hindi naman niya na outright babayaran niya itong 300,000 as an isolated transactions, no? Isama po niya ito sa ibang transaction niya kasi VAT taxpayer siya. So, kung kailan or anong date ito nangyari, isama niya dun sa sale and then compute the total output and then compute the total input sa kanya, ito isama sa kanyang VAT payable. No? Hindi niya ito babayaran na as an isolated transaction o nag-iisang transaction, babayaran na niya bukod pa doon sa talagang ipafile niya. Kasama po ito sa regular na value added tax na pinafile po ng taxpayer. So, to be considered deemed sold, there must be a transfer of ownership over the property. The transmission of property to a trustee shall not be subject to VAT if the property is to be merely held in trust for the trust. So, pag trustee, ibig sabihin yung property hindi yun binenta. Hineld for trust lang, parang in-trust mo lang sa kanya. Pero, same owner yan, no? So, hindi yan kasama na deem sold. Consignment of goods not withdrawn in 60 days. Ano bang rule natin ng consignment? Pagka after 60 days na considered sold, no? So, consigned goods to consignees, if not withdrawn within 60 days, are also presumed or deemed sold subject to VAT. No? Kasi pinakonsign mo yung goods mo, after 60 days, dapat isubject mo na siya sa VAT. Kasi nabenta man yan o hindi, binili man yan o hindi nung nag-consign, considered sold na talaga yon. So, may obligation na yung nag-consign na babayaran niya yung consigned goods. So this is not actual consumption, but the rule is apparently intended to prevent taxpayer from deferring recognition of output VAT by non-reporting or delayed reporting of the sales on consignment. Why? Kasi kung hindi mo yan bigyan ng limit, forever yan consignment, hindi i-report sa VAT for reporting purposes. Kaya binigyan niya ng 60 days na period over which considered sold na yung consigned goods. Okay, so the transfer constitutes a complete gift. The transfer is subject to VAT as deemed sales. It must be noted that the property must be an ordinary asset to be VATable. No? So yung sinabi natin kanina na real property, VATable yun, considered ordinary asset ng taxpayer. Distribution to shareholders or creditors. So, bakit ba dinistribute natin sa shareholders or sa creditors natin? Kasi pinambayad natin sa utang. Ito naman sa shareholders, pinambayad natin sa dividend nila or share nila sa profit ng company. No? So, the acquisition by shareholders of goods or properties declared as property dividends or by creditors as payment of their loans under addition in pago payment is a form of consumption. Form of consumption kasi itra-transfer mo yung ownership, which is analogous to a purchase. Hence, the distribution is deemed sold subjected to VAT. No? So, yung distribution mo, binigay mo sa shareholders or sa creditors, subject to value-added tax. No? Example, a VAT-registered taxpayer has its own sales operation but also sells goods through consignees. It also sells goods on consignment for a commission. No? So, the following were the results of operations for the month ended April 30, 2019. So, ito po yung example natin. No? Nagbenta siya ng sarili niyang inventories, 500,000. Okay, sales reported by consignees, kasi nagpa-consign siya ng goods. So, sabi ng consignee, ito yung nabenta, 150,000. Sales in behalf of consignors, 100,000. Siya naman yung nag-consign. Commission income on goods sold for consignors, 20,000. Okay. Ano yung build prices of outstanding consignments still held by consignee as of April 30, 2019 are as follows. So, for February, yung na-consign is 50,000. For March, yung na-consign pa rin is 80,000. And for April, 120,000. Ito yung kinonsign ng example natin, no? Taxpayer. So, paano tayo mag-compute ngayon? The output VAT shall be computed as follows. For direct sales, we have 500,000, which is VATable, no? Also, the sales through consignees na 150,000 since nireport na to ng consignee na sold. So, you have to declare that as sales to your VAT returns. Commission income is also subject to VAT. No? So, total is 20,000. So, the total sales or receipts is 670,000. You multiply that by 12% equals 80,400. No? So, ano yung deemed sales natin ng February? 50,000 multiplied by 12% equals 6,000. So, the total output VAT natin is 86,000. Okay. So, ano po yung explanations natin? The sale of the taxpayer include direct sales and those made by its agents or consignees. Gross commission expenses also to consignees. So, kaya nagiging kasama sa computation natin sa total gross niya subject to VAT. No? Ano yun? Yung direct sales niya, yung mga sales made by agents or consignees, at saka yung gross commission niya. The consignment sale of a consignee is not taxable to the consignee but to the consignor. Siyempre, kasi ang may-ari ng goods is the consignor. So, only the commission earned by the consignee on such sale is taxable to the consignee. On February, unsold consignment is more than 60 days old as of April 30, kaya considered sold na siya, so the current month. So, the March consignment is less than 60 days old, hence hindi pa rin siya, hindi pa considered na sold yung March na consigned goods kasi wala pang 60 days, no? Kasi ang rule natin sa consignment, kailan? 60 days considered sold. So, wala pang 60 days, hindi pa siya sold. Note, on all deemed sales transaction, the rules of VAT on deemed sales of VAT taxpayer shall apply only if, number one, the property transferred is an ordinary asset. Kasi sinabi natin na ordinary asset, held for sale, no? Ginagamit talaga siya sa business. And the property transferred is a battable property. Kasi kung hindi battable property yan, definitely hindi yan subject sa VAT. Illustration or example. Sunday Corporation, a VAT taxpayer declared its goods inventory with a production cost of 400,000 but with sales value of 600,000 as dividend to its shareholders. Okay. So, paano natin to compute? The dividend declaration of the inventory shall be deemed sold and shall be subject to output VAT as follows. Saan natin siya ibabase? Sa fair market value of 600,000. So, how much is the rate of the VAT? 12%. Multiply the fair market value of 600,000 by 12%. So, our output VAT for this transaction is 72,000. No? So, yun ang babayaran natin na value added tax. Number two, example. No? Joseph Corporation, a VAT registered lessor of commercial spaces. Ang trabaho ng Joseph Corporation, nagpapaupa ng mga commercial spaces. So, nag-declare siya ng stock investments in another corporation with a total cost of 2 million but with current value of 2,300,000, binigay niya na dividend to its shareholders, no? So, ang stocks 2 million lang pero ang value is 2,300,000, binigay niya na dividend sa shareholders. So, paano natin i-compute? The dividend declaration involving share of another corporation which is a capital asset to Astudillo Corporation shall not be subject to output VAT. Bakit? Note that even the direct sale of this investment is not subject to VAT. Bakit? Kasi exempt po yung dividend declaration by a corporation to another corporation. No? Kaya hindi siya talaga deemed sale, so hindi siya subject to value added tax. Illustration number three. Mr. Chan, a VAT registered lawyer, had a residence with a zonal value of 10 million and assessed value of 13,500,000. No, the same was foreclosed by a bank for his failure to pay his bank loan. No, so the residence is not a business property. It is a capital asset, not subject to VAT. So even if this is deemed sold, its sales is not subject to VAT. Kasi VAT registered lawyer siya, kasi yung income niya is more than 3 million, pero itong residential niya na bahay, hindi ito held for lease, no? So, capital assets, tsaka residential, so hindi talaga siya subject to VAT. Illustration 4, Juan, a VAT taxpayer, is closing his business, no? He had in his inventory 100 sacks of rice valued at 200,000. The rice inventory shall not be subject to VAT upon cessation of business, even if these are deemed sold. Their sale is not subject to VAT because they are VAT-exempt items. So, if you try to look at our National Internal Revenue Code on VAT-exempt transactions, kasama po yung rice doon. Bakit? Ano po yung rationale or reason? Bakit po yung rice hindi po subject to VAT? Kasi considered sila agricultural product in their original state. So, the simple milling is still, hindi na alter yung rice, considered pa rin siya original state, kaya hindi pa siya subject to VAT. No? Transaction not considered in sales. Number one, change of control of a corporation by the acquisition of the controlling interest of such corporation by another stockholder or group of stockholder. So, ano yun? Change of control of a corporation by the acquisition of controlling interest. Nag-change lang ng control ang corporation, pero the corporation is still the same. No? Example, ABC Corporation exchanged real estate properties held for sale or lease for the shares of stocks of DAF Corporation. So, resulting in the acquisition of corporate control. DAF has an inventory of goods amounting to 1 million. Okay. Paano po ito itatask? For what purposes? The inventories, including other properties held by DAF, shall not deem sold because the same corporation is not dissolved. ang corporation nandiyan pa rin, hindi naman siya nag-close. It's still continuing, no? So the same corporation still holds the inventory. Sa kanya pa rin yung inventory, as in walang nagbago. Yung shareholder lang nagbago. The personality of the corporation is distinct and separate from its shareholders. Kaya magbago man, magpalit man ng shareholder, the corporation is still the same. So the exchange of real estate properties by ABC is a viable sale whether or not the transaction resulted in the acquisition of corporation control, no? Kasi iba naman tong exchange real estate properties eh. Ang real estate properties kasi is a registrable property. So pagka in-exchange mo yan, meron siyang transfer, no? Kasi pati yung registration dyan, ito transfer mo. So, ano siya? Viable. Consider siya viable sale. Number two, change in the trade or corporation name of the business. So, hindi pa rin siya considered deemed sold, no? Kasi ang change lang is only the corporation name. Number three, merger or consolidation of corporation. So, hindi pa rin considered na deemed sold yung transaction. Why? Because both merger and consolidation result in the dissolution of a corporation and the transfer of the assets of the dissolved corporation to the absorbing corporation. In principle, the asset of the corporation should be considered sold. No? Under current regulations, the dissolving of the dissolved corporation is not considered deemed sold. Why? Because the unused input tax of the dissolved corporation as of the date of merger or consolidation shall be absorbed by the surviving corporation. So as if yung surviving corporation, siya pa rin lahat ng obligations, lahat ng liabilities nung na-dissolve na corporation, inabsorb lahat ng surviving corporation. No? So hindi pa rin magbabayad ng output VAT. No? Output tax on transactions deemed sales. So, the output tax on deemed sale transactions shall be based on the market value. No? Sa mga illustrations natin, sa mga examples natin given to you kanina, na yung 12% natin, the tax base, multiply po natin sa fair market value of the goods sold as of the occurrence of the deemed sale transaction. However, in the case of retirement or cessation of business, it shall be based on the acquisition cost or the current market price of the goods or properties, whichever is lower, no? Kasi pag nag-retire na ang business, no? So, acquisition cost na or current market price. Determination of fair value. How do we determine the fair value of the goods, no? Letter A, transaction is a deemed sale. Letter B, gross selling price is unreasonably lower, no? Kasi kung hindi alam ang fair value, then the commissioner shall determine the appropriate tax base. No? So, siya na yung mag-determine sa transaction deemed sale, sa unreasonably lower yung gross selling price ng property, then the commissioner will determine the appropriate value as a basis for tax na i-impose. How about invoicing requirement for subsequent sale of goods or properties deemed sold? No? So, the subsequent sale of goods or properties deemed sold shall not be subject to VAT. No? So, the seller of goods or properties previously deemed sold shall indicate the sales invoice number wherein the output tax on deemed sale was imposed and the corresponding tax paid on the item sold. No? So mag-issue siya ng resibo. For going concern taxpayer, this is essential to avoid further imposition of any business tax on the subsequent sale. This is also essential for the buyer to establish its claim of input VAT on his purchase of goods previously deemed sold to the seller. So, kailan po yung invoicing requirements natin. Deemed sales rules apply only to VAT taxpayers. Siyempre, kasi yung non-VAT, wala naman po silang babayaran na value-added tax. So, it must be noted that concept and rules of deemed sales and the taxation of the sale of ordinary assets apply only to VAT taxpayers. No? This do not apply to non-VAT taxpayers by virtue of absence of an equivalent provision in our tax law. But aside from wala provision sa tax law natin na yung non-VAT natin, may deemed sale. So, wala po siya talaga. Why? Because the rationale or common sense will dictate us na non-VAT transactions yan. So, hindi mo dapat i-consider yung VAT. Illustration. Merrier Corporation, a non-VAT merchandising business, made the following sales and consignment during the month. No? So, the sale of goods, 200,000. Sale of equipment, 500,000. Consignment, 80 days old, 100,000. So, consignment, 80 days old na, considered sold na. No? So, the percentage tax shall apply only to the 200,000 sale of goods. No? The sale of equipment and the 80-day consignment is not part of the sales of non-VAT persons. No? This is all for our transaction deemed sale for VAT purposes. And I would like to say thank you to our YouTubers now who are watching us, and also thank you for our subscribers. So for those who have not yet subscribed to us, please subscribe the tax training. We promise you to bring more tax updates or updated information in order for you to have a better tax compliance. Thank you.